So what is it with window cleaning solutions, using dish soap or putting vinegar or getting something like Glass Gleam 4? Like, why would you use that over dish soap? What's up? I'm Keith at Detroit Sponge with Mike. What's up, Mike?
Hey, Keith.
Hope you're doing awesome.
Yep.
And Mike owns a window cleaning supply tool store. He ships all over the country, and I'm here buying some stuff for my business because I'm a window cleaner. But, dude, tell us about the whole soap dilemma so we can learn the difference and why.
Sure. Well, you can obviously use a lot of different things to clean windows. One of the things that you'll read and you'll see a lot of people using are dish soap. The reality is dish soap does a good job. It gets the particles of dirt suspended in the water so that your squeegee can rip all that off the glass. It's going to work out fine for you in a lot of cases. But dish soap is not designed for use on a transparent surface that's vertical. So it does leave certain things that it doesn't do real well. You move into some of the more professional concentrates that we sell that are designed, and the chemists have designed them so that they will do things like want to retreat back to itself, to where when you wipe it or you run your squeegee across it, it makes it easier to detail the edges, doesn't push that water and spread the water as much into the edges and the rubber gaskets of your windows.
Wait.
You just said that really fast. Say that last phrase again.
Well, they design the solution so that it behaves differently because you're trying to use it on glass. So their concern is for you to be able to wipe it well from the edges and not leave any residue behind when you clean it up. With the dish soap, it's not designed that way. Dish soap's designed for dishes, which are usually washed with lots of water, but it does cut the grease and the grime. So,
sorry.
And if you're good enough at squeegeeing, I don't think it matters what you put in the bucket. If you got your probably 5-10 year badge in window cleaning, you can just clean the window with anything. But when you're training people or you're really trying to make a presentation to the customer, these solutions will make sure that they don't leave any residue behind and the windows will actually stay shinier longer. You don't get that haze, a little bit of residue that you'll see sometimes from dish soap afterwards. So the professional concentrates are also easy to use. They all have SDS sheets on them, so you can easily give it to property managers, telling them exactly what's in your bucket. It makes it a little bit more of a comfortable conversation.
Yeah. I feel like we're on QVC, man. So I'll put these below in the description if you're interested in Glass Gleam 4.
What are they? Sparkle 100?
Dazzle 100.
Dazzle 100 and Glass Gleam 4. Yep. And what are these specifically? Like, the difference between the two?
The Dazzle's a little bit more concentrated. So if you're using it on your regular stable source of water, it's a city water supply, it can work out fantastic. But you're only using a tenth of an ounce per gallon when you mix it up. When you go over to the Glass Gleam 4, it's designed so it has some buffers in there. If you just say you've gotten water before from a customer that has a well and you notice that that water behaves a little differently than the water that maybe you grabbed in the city water supply, that's because of the water softening that most people do on well water. The Glass Gleam 4 is going to stabilize and blend a little bit better for you when you're using it on that type of a variety of water sources. But either one are designed to do the same thing. Either one are considered super concentrates. The Dazzle is going to make you
a lot more. We call that the GG4.
Yeah.
GG4.
Yep.
GG4. Well, thanks, Mike. Appreciate it.
Yep. You're welcome.